Okay. Hello everyone. I'm Beatriz García Jiménez, a postdoc from Madrid in Spain, and thank you for letting me to present our work about combining microbiome with metabolic model. In our work titled Modeling Recovery of Chronic Disease by Simulating Microbial Community Dynamics Under Perturbation. Microbes do not live in isolation, but in microbial communities. Microbial communities are very relevant because they are everywhere, inside and around us. For example, in the human gut and oral microbiome, in the soils and living plants, in the air, in the water, and even inside bioreactors in synthetic microbial communities. They carry out multiple functions, such as training the immune system, providing nutrients, and synthesizing complex molecules. The interest in microbial communities has increased in the last year due to the advance in metagenomics and sequencing, because now we can know the microbes live in a community without requiring to culture in a wet lab the community. One important point for our study is that in many metagenomic studies, they compare a control versus treatment situation from an static point of view. However, we are interested in analyzing the dynamics of the microbial community. In this example, we have a community with three microbes, and we can see in the plot how the abundance or the biomass of the different microbes change over time. For example, in some points, there are abrupt increase or decrease in the biomass that usually correspond to some external perturbation. For example, the appearance of a new microbe or a change in the medium composition, in the availability of the nutrients. We can consider that there are different microbial community state or different microbiome state depending on the composition of the community, the proportion of the different microbes in the community. And some of these states could be healthier than others. For example, if we consider that the microbe C, the orang-1, is a pathogen, the state 2 and 3 would be less healthy than the state 1. So in this point, it would be great to be able to predict the perturbation to apply in the state 3 to move the community to a healthier state where the biomass of the pathogen, the microbe C, decrease. So taking this scenario in mind, we developed it NDP Bion, a computational system that was presented last year in ECCB, to move the microbial community state between different ones using external perturbation. That could be changes in diet or fertilizer in plants or whatever perturbation you want to reach a more performant or healthier state. This is a high-level schema of NDP Bion with the input experimental microbiome time series and the output personalized recommendation. If we go into detail the input, NDP Bion requires several or multiple subjects with different treatment that had been sequenced time to time. And also it's important that we collect the perturbation that has happened between the different time points. With all these time series, we go into NDP Bion, and the first things to do is to identify the microbiome state. That could be done using expert knowledge or applying clustering techniques. Then the sequence, the time series of samples could be translated in time series of state, in sequence of state, preserving the perturbation between the different time points. So with this sequence, we build a Markov decision process, the NDP, with the transition between the different states taking into account the different perturbation. And applying a solver, an NDP solver, we get the recommendation to apply in each particular state depending on the perturbation. So as an output, if you have a new subject, you take a sample, you sequence them, and you identify the state that correspond from those defining in NDP Bion. And then the system NDP Bion report the perturbation to apply, for example, in this case, a probiotic X. And this cycle could be repeated until we get that the subject move to a state, to a goal state, that in this case could be to recover from an IV disease. This would be the general schema. But here we have a challenge, that there are few experimental data about microbiome time series, and even less with the collection of the perturbation that has happened between the different time points. So here we propose to simulate data to generate synthetic data of this microbial community dynamic using genome-scale metabolic models. So the idea is to replace this experimental microbiome data with synthetic data generated with a new system we have developed called M-Mode, that I explain later, and the rest of the the pipeline preserve the same to obtain the personalized recommendation. Regarding genome scale metabolic model, there are two important things for our system. The first one is that genome scale metabolic model was originally designed for isolated strain. So when in the last year we begin to combine different metabolic models, some challenges appear. The most important one is the lack of standardization, because the genes have been developed by different authors with different nomenclature, and when you put together, it's very difficult to get that it begins to work, because there is a time-consuming task, because you have to do many translations between the different identifiers and so on. Other problems are also to define the medium composition and the chain rate at community level, but the most important one is the lack of standardization. Other point is that, again, a genome scale model was originally designed to analyze a micro from a static point of view, not from a dynamic one. So if we try to group the different methods that exist to represent microbial communities with genome scale model, we have three groups: static unified, static multipart, and dynamic. In the first one, all the genome scale models are combined in a unique stoichiometric matrix. In the static multipart, the individual genome scale models are preserved, but there are direct connections between the different models. So there is a metabolite accumulation in the medium that we need in NDP biome, because most of the perturbation that we probably go to apply will be changes in the concentration of the nutrients in the medium. And finally, the dynamic approach are the perfect one for NDP biome, because they allow us to check how evolve both the microbes abundant and the metabolite concentration in the medium. In the dynamic approaches, usually they apply dynamic flux balance analysis, where you first run the different flux balance analysis for the different models in the community in one specific time point, and then you update the medium and the biomasses, and you repeat this loop for the different time points. But here, the most important point is that you can observe that most of the methods are follow a static point of view. And there are few dynamics. So we propose a new system following a dynamic approach that has been developed by Jorge Carrasco and undergraduate student in our group, that we have called M-MODE, meaning metabolic models based ordinary differential equation simulation, that combines different properties that are required to represent a complex microbial community, such as a microbiome. Being a multi-strain, dynamic, and hybrid approach. And the most important thing is that allow us to include perturbation over time and to check how the community evolves over time. So the new system that we have called NDP Bion Gem for the genome scale model has as input different genome scale models from some microbes of interest, to combine in a microbial community, and also to define the perturbation we know that could modify the microbial community state. This information goes into M-MODE, that is a Python package that has been based on the state-of-the-art genome scale model technologies, that is the constraints-based and reconstruction analysis tools, COBRA, flux balance analysis, ordinary differential equation, and so on. And we get the simulated data of the microbial community under perturbation. And we go into NDP Bion and get the personalized recommendation. So if we apply NDP Bion gen to a specific case of study, in this case, we have selected model the human gut microbiome with the goal to recover from a Crohn's disease. Here we have selected two representatives of the three most abundant phyla in the human gut microbiome, that are Actinobacteria and Firmicutes. the first representative is Bifidobacterium adolescentis, and the second one, Faecalibacterium pregnancy. This model has been taken from SMAN 2014 publication, and here the goal is to avoid the decrease in the abundance of Faecalibacterium, because it has been defined as a symptom of the Crohn's disease. To apply NDP-Bion, we need to define some perturbation to move between the different microbiome states, and we have selected two kinds of perturbation. The first one are prebiotics, in particular, three different fiber sources. Starch, that is only metabolized by Bifidobacterium, inulin, that is only metabolized by Faecalibacterium, and fructooligosaccharides, that could be metabolized by both of them. And the other kind of perturbation is to increase the biomass of Faecalibacterium because it simulates a probiotic, because it has been defined, Faecalibacterium pregnancy has been defined as a novel promising probiotic against Crohn's disease. The other element we need to define in NDP-Bion is an utility function, that is a measure of the quality of the different microbiome states. So we have selected butyrate because this is a short-chain fatty acid that has been checked that in the Crohn's disease patient, the concentration of butyrate is lower than in healthy patients. So here the goal is to maximize the butyrate concentration. And with this schema, we simulate multiple time series, changing the initial relative abundances of these both strains. Here, we have an example of the output of M mode, and we can see how change the relative abundance biomasses of the microbes in the solid line, in the orange and the blue one, and in the dashed line, how change the accumulation of the metabolite in the medium. For example, it is relevant that here in this increase in the blue line corresponds to a simulation of a probiotic with a direct increase in the biomass of this microbe. And generating multiple of these time series and taking samples from time to time, we get multiple samples and multiple time points with different relative abundances. And this is the input of NDP-Bion, and the first point is to identify the microbiome state. In this case, NDP-Bion identifies three microbiome states, one healthy, that we have labeled as healthy, because has a higher relative abundance of Faecalibacterium than Bifidobacterium, that corresponds to the physiological condition. The opposite one, the dysbiosis state, with a higher proportion of Bifidobacterium than Faecalibacterium, and an intermediate state that we have called risky. And in this, on the red plot, you can see the sequence, the transition between different states per each subject, with one row per subject, where the red represents the dysbiosis state, the green the healthy state, and the yellow the risky state. With this information, NDP-Bion returns the probability to move between different states depending on the perturbation that has been applied. And here highlighted in red, we can see the recommended perturbation to reach a healthier state, that is inulin. And this recommendation is agreed with the literature because inulin intake promotes butyrate production to reach a bowel homeostasis. And finally, the conclusion: with NDP-Bion GEM, we compensate the lack of experimental data about microbiome time series, simulating perturbation and generating predicted personalized intervention plans. The limitation of our system are that we take the available genome-scale metabolic models with the problem of the non-standardized nomenclature. And usually, the genome-scale model, the model following the dynamic or hybrid approach, are applied to a community of a small size. And thank you for your attention. If you have some questions now, or if you want to discuss in detail, I have a poster this evening, the number F26. Thank you.
Thanks very much. Beatriz, other questions? So I'll start. Of course, it would be nice maybe to try to validate some of these predictions. Can you apply this to, let's say, animal data in a similar way? There are animal models probably.
We have now applying in plant microbiome, in soil microbiome data, that probably would be easier to validate than this case. And in this case, we are trying to minimize, maximize the speed to decontaminate the soil from an herbicide. And now we are doing the model, after we can try to contact with some experimental group to check, to validate the result.
Makes sense. Are there more questions? So if not, thanks. I'd like to thank Beatriz, but also all the speakers for great talks, but also for being perfectly on time. We are in Switzerland, so we really stick to the local